Algorithms are everywhere. Every app, every website, every business you interact with has a program working away in the background to show you what you want to see, get you to make decisions you didn't have to, and make you spend as much as you're absolutely willing to on stuff you didn't know you needed.
Amazon used an algorithm to test how much it could raise prices in a way that its competitors...
$40 more at 3 a.m. We know you want it.
The flight that was on sale for $150 yesterday is now $300. Oh, and now it's back to $150.
Well, that is likely the work of a pricing algorithm, a computer program factoring in supply, demand, and competitors' prices to adjust that price in real time.
In the country, Wendy's set to test surge pricing, so the cost of your burger would change depending on the time of day.
A month ago, Wendy's CEO Kirk Tanner announced that the fast food franchise would be introducing dynamic pricing, a system where how much you pay for a Baconator would depend on an algorithm that balanced customer demand with store capacity. According to the company's announcement, they were planning to invest $20 million into this technology before it was rightfully ridiculed across the internet. This was a win for the little guy that just wanted to clog their arteries at a predictable price point. But Wendy's only mistake was announcing their plan. Dynamic pricing is already here, and it's making inflation an essential feature. Algorithms aren't bad. They are just a tool that can be used for good or evil. And as someone whose job relies on appeasing one very particular algorithm, I would like to say that they can do some good. But since companies and their shareholders prioritize profits and user growth, algorithms in the hands of companies are going to be used as a tool to maximize profit and user growth. The algorithmification of everything we interact with has had some side effect, to put it mildly. But one such side effect that isn't as obvious as the addiction to the endless swipe is how it has made everything so expensive all the time. The book The Everything War, written by Wall Street Journal reporter Dana Mattioli, details how Amazon uses its market power to force prices up for everything you buy, not just in their online store, but in every store across America. According to the author's research, interviewing multiple businesses selling their products through Amazon, the online retailer contractually required that sellers list their goods on Amazon at their lowest price. That doesn't sound so bad. The lowest possible prices on a wide selection of products are why people like shopping on Amazon. But from those low prices, the businesses have to pay their cut to Big Daddy Bezos and pay for Amazon fulfillment, which is more expensive in most locations than regular shipping because of the emphasis that Amazon puts on same day or next day fulfillment. If a business is selling a $20 product and it costs them $5 to sell and have it shipped through Amazon, then they should charge $25 to cover their costs. But that would make it more expensive than their other sales options like traditional retailers, breaching their agreement with Amazon. So instead of dropping their prices for Amazon, businesses just raise their prices at places like Walmart, Target, and even their own website, making everything more expensive across the market. While the company was officially pressured to do away with this practice in 2019 by the Federal Trade Commission, it still happens. Only now, instead of a formal agreement between sellers and Amazon, an algorithm detects prices that are not competitive with other retailers and buries their product on the second or third page of search results, killing their business. The degree of separation between the company and its algorithm lets them claim that their automated program was just acting in the best interests of their customers without formally breaking any rules. I will leave a link to the book below. It's definitely worth a read, although unfortunately, the cheapest place you can pick it up is on Amazon. Now, the bad news is that Amazon and its algorithms are probably the least damaging to your personal finances when compared to the other algorithms slowly ratcheting down on your job, your rent, your healthcare, your insurance, your debt, and your taxes. So it's time to learn how money works to find out how mathematical models mandated inflation. This week's video is sponsored by Brain.fm, something I've been using for a while now, and I'm excited to share it with you. Brain.fm offers music designed to help you focus, relax, and sleep, all backed by science. I've been using it, and it's amazing how much it boosts my productivity. It's so much easier to start difficult tasks and stay focused without distractions. Brain.fm's team even won a National Science Foundation grant to support ADHD brains, and the app includes a special mode just for ADHD. The music changes the patterns in your brain, helping you concentrate, relax, or sleep better. They've got everything from lo-fi to classical to nature sounds, all crafted to support your brain's needs. Whether you need to dive into deep work, recharge with a power nap, or unwind after a long day, Brain.fm has a mode for you. I want you to experience this too, so I've arranged for you to get a full month of free access. Help support the channel by going to brain.fm/HMW and enjoy a month of Brain.fm for free. Trust me, it's a game changer. Give it a try. 2 months ago, the Federal Trade Commission released a statement explaining that price-fixing by algorithm is still price-fixing. The release was specifically targeted at a new type of software that was marketed towards landlords and real estate agents as a way for them to get the highest possible price for their rental property. The program in question, without even the slightest bit of self-awareness, was called Rent Maximizer. And according to the FTC, it, along with similar programs, were used to determine rental prices for tens of millions of families across America. The program uses market data, along with other proprietary systems, to come up with the highest possible price that a property can confidently be rented out at. It also uses data from all of the other property managers in the area to make sure that it wasn't recommending prices that would undercut other landlords. The FTC has concluded that this is just straight up illegal price fixing. Price fixing is an illegal act, which is when two or more businesses agree to raise their prices to maximize revenue without properly competing with one another. This is especially damaging to consumers when the product being price fixed is an essential good like food, water, or a place to live in. By using an algorithm, the software company and the landlords thought they had a degree of separation because they weren't colluding on price. They were just doing what the computer told them to. The FTC does not see it this way. The good news is that since the FTC made this release, lawmakers are pushing to make the practice explicitly illegal. The bad news is that none of the parties benefiting from this kind of price fixing are likely to be punished. And at the same time, average rents for Americans have already increased by over 30% since 2020. A report by the Joint Center for Housing Studies at Harvard University found that more than 12 million households in America are now spending more than half of their total income on housing alone before taxes, transport, and other luxury goods like food. Speaking of food, the Justice Department also sued a similar operation happening amongst meat processors who were using algorithms to set the price of their products on store shelves. According to the Justice Department, the companies that shared this algorithm were responsible for more than 90% of broiler chicken sales, 80% of pork sales, and 90% of turkey sales across all of America. But leveraging algorithms to increase the cost of the house you live in and the food you eat is still not the most damaging thing these programs are being used for. The world of medical pricing is too complicated for anyone to fully understand. Money flows between doctors, hospitals, insurers, and patients, and the system really just barely works. In between all of this, you guessed it, is an algorithm called Multiplan that has been used by several large health insurers to cut out payments to doctors and increase billing to patients. A New York Times investigation into Multiplan found that the program was dominant in creating a price for out-of-network care for patients across the country. Insurers would use the proprietary algorithm to determine how much they would pay the hospital and how much patients would have to cover themselves. As a shock to absolutely nobody, the algorithm decided that the insurers had minimal responsibility and that most of the calculated costs would come out of the patient's pockets. Rather than competing to offer better coverage to their clients, insurers could just use the lowest estimates on the Multiplan program, knowing that their competitors would just do the same, further obscuring already ridiculously opaque pricing. The insurers have claimed that this system is essential to protect them from care providers sending them outrageous bills. Large hospital chains are certainly guilty of this, but instead of combating that issue, all Multiplan really does is dump the excess cost onto the patient. Smaller healthcare providers are also being hurt by this far more than the large hospital chains, which have much more negotiating power. The New York Times report interviewed a rural doctor who had to close down the practice after Multiplan insurers slashed their rates. Patients that used to see that doctor now have to travel 2.5 hours to find another provider who is still covered under their insurance. The insurers weren't shy about doing this either. According to the New York Times report, major insurers using this program bragged about how embedded this technology was in their claims processing systems. People paying for healthcare have even less control over their spending than they do when finding a home to rent or food to eat. People also can't choose a cheaper option. People can move to a cheaper house. They can't not receive a cheaper life-saving treatment. While this looks like the same type of price fixing via algorithm as the other cases, the FTC for now has been very quiet about the healthcare industry. Now, you might think it's harder for it to get too much worse than this, but it does. Algorithms have been great tools to part you with your hard-earned money, but their most sinister use is controlling how much you earn in the first place. If you apply for a job, it's almost certainly going to go through a site like Indeed, LinkedIn, or the company's own job posting. Unfortunately, handing out your resume with a firm handshake won't get you many interviews. When you submit your application online, you're much more likely to be rejected by a program than an actual human being. A survey by JobScan found that 98% of all Fortune 500 companies use some form of application tracking software or ATS. The remaining 1.2% probably still used it, but it was just harder to detect. Sometimes this software is just a way for companies to keep their job listings organized, as some roles could have thousands of applicants. But more have started using tools to automatically find what an algorithm thinks is the most promising candidate. A report by Getty, a recruitment technology company, found that the average corporate job openings get 250 resumes. Only 4 to 6 of those resumes will be interviewed, and if applicants are lucky, one of them will get a job. The use and overuse of algorithmic resume screening has created services where programs write resumes that rank well with programs that check resumes. Just getting a job is annoying enough, but the same tools that are being used to screen candidates are now also being used to negotiate wages with new hires and existing staff. If someone demands a pay raise, companies can use these programs to estimate how much they would need to pay a replacement, and if there is no cost benefit to them, they won't grant the pay increase. Most career guidance professionals will encourage you to do your research on the job market before negotiating a starting salary or a pay raise. Unfortunately for you, there is no reasonable way for a regular employee to have access to as much market data as a company with thousands of applications on file in a proprietary ATS system. Now, I'm going to be writing an article on similar algorithms being used to catch tax and welfare cheats. It might sound like a good use of technology, but it's been tried before with literally deadly consequences. It also never really catches the people it actually needs to. That article will be going out to my free email newsletter this week, so if you're interested, you can sign up at the link below. Now, all of this is done in the name of maximizing shareholder value. If you want to know about a man who believed that the solution to office space was algorithms, check out our video on Masayoshi Son to see why he was horribly wrong. As always, don't forget to like and subscribe to keep on learning how money works.